Ma très chère Elina, dear Director Tillman, ladies and gentlemen, hyvää iltaa, good evening, guten Abend, einen sehr schönen Abend. We are here at the Film Institute to celebrate the Finnish film, the history of Finnish film and the Finnish contemporary film. We all expected to have this evening completely different than we now have it. We had the extremely sad news of Peter von Baag, who left us 3 weeks ago, and this evening is going to be an homage to his work and to his memory. We will have a different program as was planned, but I'm sure that we will have an evening full of memories and full of also professional baggage that we can take back home. Aki Kaurismäki was another person that we long to meet here and to see here and discuss with him, but unfortunately for personal reasons he's unable to come to Frankfurt, but he sends you all his very best greetings for a nice festival and for this very interesting carte blanche cycle that Peter von Baag had time to establish for you. But we have here Elina Salo, who came from directly from Paris with a very, very short notice. Elina Salo has a fantastic career as one of the most interesting and important artists, actresses in Finland for all of us, a dear actress and an old friend of Peter von Baag, of course, but also an actress of choice of Aki Kaurismäki. Elina, you have worked with Aki also in almost most of his films, and you are really one of her actresses of choice, really. My name is Iris Schwank. I'm director of this Finnish Guest of Honor project, Finland.cool project at the Frankfurt Book Fair. This Frankfurt Book Fair frame is a great opportunity to present Finnish culture all over the city of Frankfurt. And I would very warmly thank the Film Museum and Film Institute here to host the two cycles, the cycle of Aki Kaurismäki, the retrospective of his films, and then this carte blanche choice of Peter von Baag. Finnish culture is very present all over the place, and as our slogan Finland.cool. indicates, we want you to get more familiar of our culture that is both cool, meaning everything, it's cold, but it's also surprising, it's arrogant sometimes, it's warm as well, extremely warm in fact, and really full of surprises. And I wish that you could go to the book fair during the weekend, that you could go to the museums and of course enjoy La Carte Blanche selection of Peter von Baag. I take this opportunity to thank all the partners, not only the Film Museum and Film Institute, but Sodankylä Film Festival. We've had a great cooperation. We have been preparing this for 2 years, or at least. I'd like to thank the Finnish Film Foundation, who made it possible, these two big series here, and Kaava, the Finnish Film Archives, and Like Publishing House, who has just published a very, very beautiful film about the Sodankylä Film Festival. I wish you all a wonderful evening, full of memories and a very interesting plunge into Finnish culture starting from here at the Film Institute. And one more time, huge thanks, Elina, for being with us. Now I would like to give over the micro to Claudia Dillmann, who is the director of the Finnish Deutsches Filmmuseum, Deutsches Film Institute. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mrs. Schwank. So, dear Mrs. Schwank, dear Elina Salo, dear Timo Malmi and Ari Lehtola, and all the members, of course, of the staff of the Midnight Sun Film Festival, my dear guests, we heard it. To our deepest regret, Peter von Bach is no longer with us, and I can say we truly miss him, and not only here and tonight when he would have presented his most recent book, the English edition of Sodankylä Forever, Masters of Cinema Under the Midnight Sun, and the German edition of the interviews with his friend Aki Kaurismäki. Finally, he would surely have said, with some mockery as to him, when it came to the publishing of his books or the screening of his films, the Germans sometimes seem to be even slower than the Finns, and for sure slower than the French or the Italians. So finally, but in a way definitely too late, here we are with his books and his films 3 weeks after his death. This year's Frankfurt Book Fair, with, to quote the Mestari, Finland as its Disneyland, has been carefully planned by Peter von Bach for quite a while. Tonight, many of his friends and colleagues are among the audience, and I would like to emphasize that it is an honor for us to share with you this special evening, which sadly has become to a tribute in memoriam. A cordial welcome to all of you, to you who are so familiar with his personality, his thoughts, his work, who deeply understand the role he has been playing for Finland's cultural life, and the affection of his fellow countrymen given to him for such a long time. And a sincere welcome to my non-Finnish colleagues, the archivists, scholars, programmers, students, who luckily have witnessed him in our international contexts. And last but not least, a warm welcome to the general audience, probably a minority tonight, but one that Peter would have truly appreciated. Please allow me some words about the director of the film you are going to see tonight and the author of the aforementioned books, who is probably rather unknown to our German visitors, even to those interested in Finnish films and culture. Peter von Bach was the author of more than 40 books dedicated to popular culture, film history, and the cultural history of Finland, awarded with the Finlandia Book Prize in 2007. A passionate, long-time programmer of the Finnish Film Archive, the spirit and the voice of hundreds of Finnish radio programs about cinema, the publisher of most important books, as well as half-forgotten popular music, having run companies labeled Love, and he meant it. He was the wild young director of short feature films in the 60s, followed by his only full-length feature, his notorious The Count of 1971, in which Elena Salo played at a leading role. He was the inspired and inspiring director of numerous TV series on Finnish life and history, the teacher and professor, and the director of extraordinary film essays based on archival material, for which he gathered praise also internationally. The Rotterdam Perspective and Retrospective of 2012 being his breakthrough. But little of this is unfortunately known in our country. So for Peter, the Frankfurt Book Fair seemed to be a fine chance to finally enlighten the German audience as well. Finland, the faraway country. 20 years ago, this extraordinary man was envying us, his Central European colleagues, for our short distances to every place that counted in his eyes, Paris on top. He used to sign his postcards in his incredible handwriting with Peter the Siberian, even when he had just met with Roman Polanski in Paris. He sent greetings, sitting in front of my igloo. Thus, in this or that way, luring to the general ignorance towards his small home country. Well, we knew Aki Kaurismäki's films and perhaps those of his brother Mika, but no others. And we had probably read Sinuhe the Egyptian without taking much notice of its Finnish origin and its writer Mika Waltari. Sibelius, yes, Aalto, too. Emma Numinen in specialized circles. And that was it. Which probably underlaid Peter's Siberia and igloo jokes with some sincere suffering. Being already a well-known figure in Finnish cultural life at home, he felt like a miserable and useless outsider abroad. At least he said so. Peter loved, overstatements as much as superlatives. Nevertheless, as a Finn with German roots and relatives, with a family's background in St. Petersburg, speaking English, French, Italian, Swedish, and some other languages, he refused to tolerate being put into the margins like his country happened to be. So he made himself a center. The keywords are Pordenone, with its silent film festival, and Bologna, with its Il Cinema Ritrovato, festivals which are essential in our world, in our work as film archives and film museums. Already an estimated friend of some colleagues from this sphere, Peter became famous, acknowledged, and admired by the international community of archivists, programmers, preservation specialists, and scholars within a time span of only a few years. In 1995, he had started to write himself into the hearts of these professionals with wild texts, until then unread of in official publications, with essays titled, for example, Sing Me a Nice Sad Song About Kissing and Killing. And sentences like this, Pordenone and Bologna demonstrate that the best symposia take place spontaneously and obey only the rules of heaven. True Peter, his style, and the astonishment of the archival world, our sometimes dry, not always so passionate community, whose master of ceremonies he would become in 2001 when he took over Bologna as the artistic director of the festival. Beaming like a child being invited into a candy shop, this intellectual strictly demanded to make his ideas about cinema and life come true, since has led Bologna to become the world's most important and also biggest film historical festival. Tonight we gather in a cinema. But what is cinema? What does it mean in our personal life, in our memories, in society, in history? Cinema and life, sometimes converging, sometimes not. Movies bigger than life, films as the real life, the one with a capital, the one that counts. Films and our memories building a shadow history of the 20th century, perhaps the true history. These were thoughts Peter von Bach had spread before the eyes of his first international readers already in the previously mentioned Bologna essay of 1995, in which two of his so-called ghost projects can also be found. One being the proposal to collect voices, tapes, filmed interviews of directors and cinematographers. Quote him, "There should ideally be one place on earth where all this material could be found and not a closed place." Well, has there ever been an idea dear to him which he gave up? Probably not. Thus, almost 20 years later and some days after his death, the Criterion Collection, one of the most important DVD production companies worldwide, could announce, "Along with the entire film world, we are grateful that Peter von Bach devoted so much of his time to interviewing many of our greatest directors, leaving behind him a treasure trove of insightful discussions about life and cinema. Earlier this year, with his blessing, we made a home here at Criterion for his archives, including more than 120 filmed interviews and even more in audio recordings." Well, a great part of this treasure has been collected in Sodankylä, Lapland, Finland, at the Midnight Sun Film Festival since its first edition in 1986, founded by Aki and Mika Kaurismäki and Peter von Bach. It has been attracting numerous directors into the nowhere of northern Finland, where nothing can be found but the pure cinema experience in a small town. A concentrated around-the-clock experience during the white nights, when the sun won't go down, thus causing, at least in my case, the severest forms of jet lag one can imagine. The festival's first year welcomed Samuel Fuller, Bertrand Tavernier, Jonathan Demme, to be followed by other masters of cinema under the midnight sun, whose faces, voices, ponderings, memories, work reports have been recorded, forming the treasure trove, so valuable and not only for film historians. We owe these precious insights into the personalities of so many important filmmakers, not only to the 2 hours duration of the talks or to the democratic, claimer-free atmosphere of this festival beyond the Arctic Circle, but mostly to Peter von Bach's ability to bring his guests into a talkative mood. They trusted him, who knew their works by heart, being one of the profoundest film historians in the world and a director himself. Sodankylä Forever, the century of cinema, is the film you are about to see tonight, the first of 4 parts based on the Sodankylä interviews. Fascinated by principles of collage and compilation, which allowed him to create his own dreamlike image of a town, like in his film Helsinki Forever, or of Finland, like in his Sininen Laulu, Peter von Bach introduces us in this filmic essay to ideas of cinema, life, and history. A fascinating document, just like his book, compiling these interviews in written form. Or, as he wrote, "The book forms a kind of dialogue in heaven. Many of the filmmakers who participate in the conversations may never have met in the real world. But why should we allow that, not to mention the borderline between life and death, to limit us? Many of those who speak in this book are already gone, but their voices and their works are present to us in a very tangible way. So are his voice and his works to us. And thank you very much. So, now let's go in the mood with the special world of the Midnight Sun Film Festival. We first show a trailer, afterwards Timo Malmi, program director of the festival, will have a talk with Elena Salo, the actress in 7 Kaurismäki films, and also in Peter von Bach's The Count. Thanks a lot.
Friends, although it's sad that Peter von Bach can't be here with us tonight, it's great to hear his unique voice and to see him on the screen. And in spite of all this sad news, we are very happy to launch his book, Sodankylä Forever, Masters of the Cinema Under the Midnight Sun, published by Rosebud, finally here. And this is very important because it was one of his greatest dreams to have this book released in English abroad. Although he had made so many books, as you heard, and done so many films, etc., and was so productive, this book was most important for him, and also this film, this documentary series, you will see the first part soon. And why? I think that the first thing is that this festival was so close to his heart. It was maybe the most important thing in his life in cinema. Those discussions there, which he held for 2 hours, morning discussions with all these famous film directors, special guests, over hundred of them. He loved them and was so enthusiastic to talk with them. And that's why this book that is, in a way, edited like a film of these discussions is unique in the whole world. There are hundreds or thousands of film festivals in the world, but no festival has ever published a book like that because Peter von Bach was able to do that. And it was also for him so important to have this film, this for documentaries released and shown, and now we have a privilege tonight to see the film and to have the book finally. And so it's a great pleasure, and we are honored to be here and most happy in this respect. And now I'm so happy to ask to the stage the most charming actress of Finland of all times, Elina Salo.
Well, he was a dinosaur, really, as you see. Well, anyway, and Sodankylä, he was the best interviewer I know, because he, at 9 o'clock in the morning, when the all the directors had drank a bit, you know, and seen the film, the last film begins at 3 o'clock in the morning, and it's light. When you go to the cinema tent, it's the sun is shining, and so they come to this Peter's interview at 9 o'clock, so they have slept probably 2 hours, and they have to take all these questions he asked them, and they have to be honest. They are, you know, no between, no bling bling in that world. You have to be honest and think. And Peter had a wonderful way of, you know, taking everything out of them in these 2 hours. So
Elina, let me tell us tell you that she was there interviewed in 1993, so she knows.
I know it, yes. And yeah, you don't sleep. You just have the films and reindeers and nothing else. Oh, you have something to eat all the time. If you go to the one street that goes in the little village, you can have a mikä se on,
a reindeer.
Reindeer or kanankoipi.
Chicken,
yeah. Yes. And then you go to the other film, you know, and so on. So there is an ambience. There's no bling bling at all, no money, no luxury, no. It's just good films. And I saw at 3 o'clock in the morning, I went to see Victor Sjöström's He Who Got Slapped, you know, the wonderful, with an orchestra playing, a wonderful film of old days, yes, a silent film, so you can...
Just a tiny question at first. You are among the very few people that have seen Peter's forgotten masterpiece, his first film called Life in Finnish Forests. And I know that it was somehow very, very important for you. Can you tell a little about it?
Yeah, we were all absurd in the 60s. I knew Peter from 1961, and he was 18 years old. I was a bit older anyway. So the first film, this, but the other film he made with my husband, Pertti Maisala, who I'll talk first about this other film, short film, which name is Pock Pickett. Pock Pickett. It was an homage à Bresson, Pock Pickett, pickpocket. So it was about a rich young. It's a rich boy who puts money to other people's because he has got so bad conscience. He goes and picks, you know, there. Wonderful film, a short one, but this short one that you made, what was the name of it in English?
Life in Finnish Forests.
Yeah, it's 45 seconds. And Peter rushes in the woods of Finland, nothing but trees, and loves them, you know. Like that. That was, the first.
Yes, when we invited you to Midnight Sun Film Festival, you said that you will come if this film will be shown.
Yes.
But he and didn't. It was done somehow.
Yeah.
But after that, the film is
disappeared.
Lost. Yes.
Oh, terrible.
If you find it, bring it to us.
And then the other thing is that he had this Fuji cinema filmihullu, the idiot, what is it? how do you
movie crazy
which started at 67 or something like that.
68
yes. A film, a good wonderful film magazine. Yeah, il est. And then I have to quote the director of a Finnish Film Archive when asked who can replace Petter von Baag, and he answered, "Oh, 100 persons. No, that's terrible. That's it.
Let me ask a little about the only long fiction film that Petr made. It's a real cult film brought to The Count, and you were acting in it. What kind of experience was that?
Well, you have to see it, you know, because it was a real person, a count. No, he was not a count, but he was in the papers. He was like a, how do you go?
Yes, he was a Don Juan.
Don Juan,
who had a record of he had engaged more
prison.
Finnish girls than anybody else.
Yeah. And I don't know why Petr loved him. I think he envied this man a bit, something like that must be the first reason why did he choose him for the first long film he made, and he had no script for it. He could tell anything he wanted. And I had to be in love with him. We were four girls that shows in the picture. And the most energy of me was to imagine that I could love him, because it took my all energy to think of that, because he was, you know, he's just, you have to see him. It's impossible. And then think of me when I look at him. And so it was great, because he talked as he wanted, and you have to follow him, improvising, you know. So it was a very very queer. That's it. Yeah.
We have heard how productive Petr von Bach was, and how much we have lost. What did Petr mean to you personally?
My God, he's an old friend, a family friend, because my husband and my girl, he made those short films in the 60s with my husband. Lucia film, I don't know if it's
called December, Joulukuu.
December, yes. And there is my little girl, who was 2 years old, and Petr took a little phrase, because she came down to the TV room, and we were with my husband looking at the news, and my little girl just said, what is there? And we said, it's just the Vietnam War. Who directed it? It was a girl from a film family, you know. So he had always sort of, who directed it? And that's, who directed it? And she tells that in the Petr took it, you know, the phrase. And then there is the Petr Bug answers, who invented it? It was
invented by maybe Lyndon Johnson.
Lyndon Johnson, and then it a long phrase which the father tells, and that's Petr, not my Zala, not my husband, but a very long phrase to the little girl who invented it. Johnson and a terrible cup of soldier men there in the, and so on. So terribly, very well described. I don't remember anymore, but it was a long phrase for the little girl. So, is he, he's, I can't imagine he's dead, so he's so, how can I tell? And he had that's what I tell in the last, then we'll see the film. He had a talent for taking all the art forms in a century historically and put them together and analyze the situation of our Finnish history. And he has such films he made now terribly recently. Lastuja, what was the name of English? Lastuja.
Mikko, how do you... Shivers, yes.
Shivers. And it's a wonderful thing because he took really all the century of when we got our independence and so on, and all the painters and singers, everything in the long kaari, mikä on kaari? Arches from history to our days in the same film. Yeah, that's what only he could really combinate. He gathered everything.
And yes, he made such collages. That was his speciality. Yeah. And he has described this book and this film as a heavenly discussion among all these directors, of whom so many have died already. But now we can imagine in a way that when Peter is not here, he is in heaven, in cinema paradise, talking with all these directors that he loved. So let's dedicate this screening to the great memory of our dear friend Peter von Bach.
Yeah, humor and courage. And I said, you have to see many times the films because they are filled up with such things. What you see one time, you can't. It's not enough because he has a tempo that, oh my God, you can't. And then you see another time and third time, then you really see what he has done. So
cinema, Sodankylä Forever, Century of Cinema.
Dear Elena Salo, dear Timo Malmi, all dear guests from the Midnight Sun Film Festival, dear visitors of our cinema, you all came here tonight not only to see Aki Kaurismäki's film L'Havre, but to listen to the masterful director talking to the likewise masterful cineast Peter von Bach. Sadly, none of the two can be here with us tonight. You might have heard that Peter von Bach, author, film director, co-founder of the legendary Midnight Film Sun Festival, hero of the archival world, artistic director of our film festival in Bologna, Il Cinema Retrovato, and close friend of many of us, passed away 3 weeks ago. This evening is dedicated to him. To make news worse, Aki Kaurismäki had to cancel his trip to Frankfurt, which he was determined to make in honor of his friend Peter, on short notice due to personal reasons. Fate is not on our side these days. But I'm very glad and grateful that Elina Salo, the much admired, wonderful Finnish actress, agreed spontaneously to take the train from Paris to Frankfurt today. Welcome, Elina. It's our pleasure to have you here tonight, and a warm applause for you. Thank you. Elina is connected to both Peter von Bach and Aki Kaurismäki. She played a part in Peter's early feature film, The Notorious The Count, made in 1971. And she was a frequent guest at Midnight Sun Film Festival in Sodankylä, Lapland, Finland. And she is, of course, connected to Aki Kaurismäki due to her many roles in his early and his recent films, be it The Match Factory Girl of 1990, Take Care of Your Scarf, Tatiana of 1994, Drifting Clouds, 1996, Juha of 1999, The Man Without a Past in 2002, or Love, which you are going to see tonight. I would also like to welcome and to present to you Timo Malmi. He is the program director of the Midnight Sun Film Festival in Solankylä and will now speak and talk with Elina about Aki's work and working with Aki. I would like to welcome you both, and now please take the floor and let us enjoy this evening, which is so difficult out of many reasons, but I think we will manage it in the spirit of Peter von Bach and also Aki. Thank you.
And yes, Peter is away, and I have to first to remember one thing, that in Aki's films, me and Peter, we had little parts, small parts, very often. Peter is there, not in this film, Le Havre, but in other, Peter is in some, one scene acting. And so I was always thinking that we are the mascots, the talisman of Aki, to be somewhere in the film.
When did you at first meet Aki, and what was the first film? Is it Hamlet Goes Business?
Yes. Some 80s, something, 86 or something like that. I'm very bad at years.
Do you remember how it all started?
Yes, I was busy in theatre, because that's my main thing. I was in a Swedish-speaking little theatre in Helsinki, and I had too much to do, so I said, no, I can't do this. And so they then I said yes, because that was Hamlet Goes Business. I was doing the Gertrude, the Hamlet's mother. Yeah.
And how is it worked with Aki as an actress, with the director like Aki, who is famous, for example, those takes that he maybe takes all the, chooses only one take and that's all.
That's it. He's extraordinary, because in Hamlet Goes Business there was no manuscript. He wrote it somewhere upstairs, and then he came day by day with the paper, and could you say this, and so is he doing very often. Even Le Havre, he made some scenes. He wrote by the night. And then he came and said, oh, will you please try this? And he's very, very, and the dialogue is wonderful. I think I love Aki's dialogue, because it's so funny with humor. And it's not the, I don't know if it's in this Le Havre, but in other films, it's quite stylized language. We call it Aquilien, because it's not a perfect Finnish. It's more literally, and if you change a word, no, absolutely you have to speak it with all the exact. Absolutely exact. And that's a good thing, because it gives a stylization for the, like his, it goes into the picture, because he's taking all that, it's not necessary, he takes it away. If there is a table, so there is only the necessary things, but nothing else. No handkerchiefs, no paper. It's clean.
So he knows what he is doing. Is there any room for improvisation, or is
not much, very little? But as the pictures is a bit stylized, like Edward Hopper, you know, the painter. It's quite the colors are taken from him. He loves Edward Hopper very much. And well, what did you ask?
Can improvise at all?
Oh, terribly little. You can you can do it so that he doesn't know, not in the language, but in something you do. And I've done it sometimes, you know, and it goes away. He's very content about that. Content. C'est quoi content?
Content. And if we go to the film we are seeing soon, Le Havre, which was screened in Cannes Film Festival 3 years ago in competition, and many critics thought that it's the best film at the festival. It starts the trilogy of the films that happen in harbor towns in Europe, and this time in France, which is for you very familiar because you live half a year in France. And you have this role of Claire. Can you tell a little about this role you have in this film, which, by the way, earned her the Jussi statue, which is a Finnish Oscar of the best supporting female role in 3 years ago.
Well, Le Havre, he liked the city because it was turned down, you know, and built in 50s, you know, all that. And then there is the old thing, old part of it, which was there, and it was empty. So he could lend the building, the old buildings, and he could do the scenery, who makes the scenario. No, the lavastus.
Designer
could do the bar for which I was the boss. You know, I often in his films I am the capitalist who owns very and so on. So he could do the with his colors, with his all the movements. There was no bar in that house at all, but they created it, and his wife Paula Oinonen made the pictures on the wall, painted them as I think Aki gave photos that paint this kind of a picture and so on. So they work together, and they're always there are the les chiens, the dogs of Aki. I think here too there is a dog, and in nearly every film there is one of Aki's dogs. He's got them two, three dogs, and they are nearly the main part.
And Laika got awarded in Cannes Film Festival by the prize of Palme d'Or year.
Wonderful, I didn't know that.
And I just got a German edition of Aki Kaurismäki book here, and although this film is made in France, there are many Finnish actors, and for example the cinematographer is the same Finn Timo Salaminen who has been working with Aki from the beginning, so that his usual crew is there. And
the subject is so It's well, you know when you see it, but it's with the humor of Aki. So he is always the humor and a fairy tale in, well, anyway, it's not so sad that you think. The subject, I mean, it's so relevant today. It's terribly, very, very dead.
When we are a bit late, we don't keep you long, but have you already got about to the next film of Aki's, and where will it will be shot? In Germany, perhaps? Do you know?
No, I've told Aki that now I'm nearly 80 years, so I think I'll be in a poster somewhere, just to be a talisman there somewhere, if he wants me to, because he's a wonderful person to do films with. And what we were talking about, he's not, the money is not Sister Sebastia, it's not.
The money is secondary
thing to him always. He's but the food is good when you are filming with him. He sees, yes, that you can have energy to film. So you have to eat good. That's it.
Food is important. Le Havre by Aki Kaurismäki. Thank you, Elina. Oh, yeah. Elina Salo. This book is the first German edition of Peter von Bach's Aki Kaurismäki book, and so it's very important, and you can buy it from the bookshop. No,
of course you can buy it, but that was not the question.
Okay.
But you know, as I said before, Peter always said Germans are even slowlier than Finns when it comes to his books and his films to be screened or to be published in Germany, because this book has been published before in Italy and in France, and he really wanted, and he dreamt of, that not only the Sodankyler Forever book, which we presented this evening, but also this book, his wonderful, let's say, interviews, discussions, talks with Aki Kaurismäki, the two were friends for a very long time, that this book is at the end finally published in German as well. And during this book fair, it should have been presented this evening, and I think he was in a way very proud that finally it managed to be here in Germany as well available. I think it's a wonderful book, and it is a wonderful, let's say, proof of their friendship and the way they are discussing, the way they are speaking, and the way they are joking with each other, something they did before and many times at the Sodankyler Film Festival, Midnight Sun Film Festival as well. So I think it's kind of testimonial for their friendship and their close relation. And as Elena said, yes, also Peter performed in a way with cameo, little small things in several of Aki's films, and he also gave ideas for scripts for the films. That's what I would like to say, because this evening, the entire evening, is dedicated to the memory of Peter von Bach, and also the films we are showing during the next days means we are screening, we are showing another two of his films, Peter von Bach films. One is Helsinki Forever, a compilation film based on material, historical material, archival material, and a kind of dream about the Finnish capital Helsinki. And the other is one, a marvelous film of Peter. It's Muistoja, first premiered in 2013, last year, in Sodankylä, and it's about his childhood and youth in Oulu, in northern Finland, but also a part, not only a portrait of the city, of the town, but also of a certain time in the 50s, which is quite amazing. That's all I would like to add.
I would like to add about these two guys that last summer, on the last day of the festival, we were having an interview of Aki Kaurismäki by Peter von Bach. But there was a certain change that Aki interviewed Peter. And they were such a nice friends to each other. And for us in the Midnight Sun Film Festival, Aki is also, of course, very important as a filmmaker, but also as the founder of the festival with his brother Mika and the third director Anssi Mänttäri, who got the idea to found the festival. And from the beginning, they invited Peter to be the artistic director and the boss of the festival, and that's how it has went for almost 30 years. So,
thank you.
Thank you.